the blues provide a great backdrop for improvisation. What is improvisation? Well, let's begin with a basic definition. To improvise means to compose, play, or recite or sing on the spur of the moment, and to make or provide or arrange from whatever materials are readily available, whatever you have on hand. Normally, we do not think of music as materials. It's not like you can physically touch a note. But within every song, there's what we call a tonality. And what this means is the scales, the chords, and notes that the song is built off of and around. In our case, we've been working with the C major blues, and this means that the song is built around the C scale, uses chords from that scale, and that the particular flavor is the blues. So this adds some predefined choices as far as the style of emphasized notes, chords, and even just kind of the vibe of music we want to create. Many people think that they cannot improvise because they can't, quote, think of something in the moment. The reality is that performers don't just randomly make something up. Rather, they put things together from their previous knowledge about the music's tonality and style and their own personal style. And then they practice the skill until they can do it in a way that appears spontaneous. My jazz professor in college was always talking about developing a toolbox of ideas that you could use. Only instead of tools, he meant cool musical ideas that we call hooks. We call them hooks because they grab that listener in, and they're a lot of fun. Okay, so how do we come up with cool musical ideas and practice them so we can do them spontaneously? Here are a few suggestions. Number one, keep it short. 4 to 8 beats. And remember, you don't need to fill every beat with sound. That's not the same as 4 to 8 notes. Rests are a smart choice as well. Number two, try to create accents by either adding them physically, playing the note a little bit louder, or by where you place the notes on the beats of the measure so that it creates a little rhythmic surprise. Number three, note choice. Is the note in the chord? If not, use it with intention. For example, in one of the examples I'm going to show you, I play an F in that first chord, and there is no F in the C chord. But the next chord after those series of C chords is an F chord. So I introduce that F chord a little bit ahead of time, it's a little bit spicy, and then when the F chord catches up, then it's like, ah, it's just right there in the tonality of that chord. So by that, I'm actually doing that thing I always talk about of creating a little bit of variety or contrast and then bringing it back to unity. Once you've planned out your hooks, it's time to practice them until you can perform them with confidence. When you perform your hook, you want to nail it. You want to show that confidence and that sassiness that you meant to do what you did. It can be a little scary, but with practice, you'll get great at it, especially if you use a metronome. Rhythm is everything. You'll get there. Remember to keep your hook short, 4 to 8 beats. A lot of times our biggest challenge when we're learning to write hooks and improvise is we have too much going on in our brain. We have too much to say, and then people kind of lose the point. So what I'm going to do right now is play you an example of 3 hooks that I created to go over C major blues. Here's number one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 1, 2. All right, so in this first example, it only uses 2 different notes. I use G and I use F. But a couple things I did. Number one, instead of starting at the first beat of the measure, I started on the 3rd beat to just, again, create a little bit of contrast. And then I added that F note like I told you I was going to do. The F is not in a C chord, but when the F chord comes around, now all of a sudden I'm actually playing the root of the chord, so it makes it a super strong choice. Okay, here's my second example. 2, 3, 4, 1. 4, 1. All right, now in this one, instead of the notes moving right next to each other, there's some steps I'm jumping over. So I'm going D to B flat and then A, G. So that right there is a tonal choice that just creates a little bit of spice. Secondly, I'm using a B flat, and that is the 7th note in the C scale and I'm lowering it by half step. When we talk in music about blue notes, that is exactly the kind of thing we do. We lower a note by half step. It just gives it that sense of the blues, heavily used in both blues and jazz. And here is my final example. For this example, I am literally going to use one note, but I'm going to make it cool with my hook just because of where I place these notes. So here we go. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3. One note, but I place it on the fourth beat and I accent the and of four, bringing a little bit of contrast and surprise in there. All right, now if I wanted to put these hooks together, it might sound something like this. 2, 3, 4, 1. And with that, I actually created an entire solo verse on the 12-bar C major blues, just connecting those three little musical ideas that I had previously created. Now, I've been doing this for a long time, so it's pretty easy for me now to come up with a lot of ideas just randomly in the moment. But they're not random, really, because I've spent a lot of time filling my own musical toolbox with ideas, with hooks that I can then place within my solos to get a lot of energy and spice into them. So here's a recap of strategies to help you create your first musical hooks. Choose a short musical idea that you can accurately play. 4 to 8 beats in length is plenty. Give it some contrast. Can you do something with the rhythm? Maybe syncopation or maybe adding rests. Or how about the tonality? Is there a spicy note, something a little more colorful you can add, something that's not in the chord but leads well into a future chord? And then finally, try playing that hook over the entire chord progression of the 12-bar blues, noticing how it sounds over the top of the different chords. Finally, I encourage you to record your musical ideas, even just with like a cell phone audio, because the more you get those ideas down, the more you'll discover that you have some pretty great ideas. The more you do it, the more you can refine your ideas. And also, be sure to use that metronome. It'll help keep you accountable so that when you're playing live with real instruments, you'll be able to stay right with the band. And most of all, have fun. There isn't really a wrong answer when you're creating your own musical ideas, especially improvisation. But it's really important that you're authentic to your own musical voice.